Namaskar, hello, and a very warm welcome to CIET and CRT's live phone in interactive program. मैं हूं तन्वी खुराना और साइंस के आज के इस कार्यक्रम में हम पढ़ने वाले हैं स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द एटम. क्लास नाइन्थ के सभी बच्चे हमारे साथ जुड़ सकते हैं, बातचीत कर सकते हैं, कोई सवाल है स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द एटम से जुड़ा हुआ तो आप हम तक पहुंचा भी सकते हैं. इस वक्त आप हमें देख रहे हैं ई विद्या चैनल नंबर 9 पर और साथ ही साथ हमारे यूट्यूब चैनल NCERT PM ई विद्या चैनल नंबर 9 पर भी. आप हमें चाहे तो फ़ोन भी कर सकते हैं और अपने क्वेश्चंस रेज कर सकते हैं. नंबर है 8800440559. और अगर ईमेल करना चाहें तो ईमेल आईडी होगा dth.class9@cit.nic.in. आइए आपका परिचय करवाएंगे हमारे आज के मेहमान से, जो हमें स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द एटम के बारे में बहुत सारी डिटेल्स देने वाले हैं. चलिए मिलते हैं डॉक्टर अमन भारद्वाज से. सर, अ वेरी वार्म वेलकम टू यू.
नमस्ते मैम, थैंक यू.
नमस्कार सर. सर हैं असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर रीजनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ एजुकेशन भुवनेश्वर NCERT से. तो चलिए सर से हम बातचीत शुरू करेंगे और समझेंगे सबसे पहले कि इसी टॉपिक को हमने कुछ दिन पहले भी किया था सर, तो एक छोटा सा रिकैप देना चाहेंगे आप, क्योंकि ये चैप्टर उसी के कंटिन्यूएशन में है. एक छोटी सी बात कि हमने पहले उस प्रोग्राम में क्या किया था और आज हम क्या कंटिन्यू करने वाले हैं सर.
Okay, ma'am. So, good afternoon, dear students. So, in the last session, we are discussing about the evolution of structure of atom. So, we will take the brief recapitulation of that, what we have done in the last class. And in today's class, we will discuss about the structure of atom, then the electron distribution in the orbitals and the symmetric orbital structure. Then we will discuss the valency, atomic number and mass number, along with the notation of atom in the periodic table. And at last, we are discuss about the two terminology that's given in your syllabi, is the isotopes and isobar. So basically, you know, in the last session, we are discussing about the evolution of a structure, means how the structure is grown and how we will reach out to it. So, you know, in the ancient Greek and Indian philosophers and thinkers, they will say that the structure is something which is the fundamental building blocks of any matter, and it can be, you know, cut it to the smallest part. That's the basically their thinking they explained to us. In the 1903, the John Dalton, which is an English school teacher, first time come up with a model, and he said that, you know, a solid sphere is there that can be a atom, that is atmos, which is uncuttable, means Greek language word atmos, which means is uncuttable. Then after, you know, sometime J.J. Thomson will come with a plum pudding model, or you can say it watermelon model, in which you have a negatively charged distribution all over, positively there and negatively embedded on it. Then after, you know, 6-7 years later, the Rutherford model is come, which is near about a good model, which based on the nuclear gold film experiment is there, that said that nucleus is something which is inside is, which is positively charged, and electrons are revolving in a particular path. But there is an issue, because when the charged particle is revolving, after some time, due to the energy loss, you know, that electron is merged to the nuclei and atom can be disappeared. But this doesn't happen in the real life. So after a few years, 2 years back, the planetary model come through the Bohr's model, which is, you know, your course is there. Till course you have learned the Bohr models, Niels Bohr model, which said that electrons are, you know, revolving in a particular spatial path, which called the orbit or energy level, in which while they are revolving the electrons, they does not lose their energy. So they continuously rotate it. And after that, I'll also discuss at that time little bit about the quantum model that you will read in the 11th class in your senior classes, in which the, you will understand the how these, you know, these orbitals are not, they are the electrons clouds actually, and then you will discuss about SPDS orbital. So that till now we have discussed it. So basically, you know, you have an idea ki that atom is something which is containing mainly three subatomic particle. In your course, only three subatomic particle we are discussing, which is your proton, neutron and the electron. You know, your proton and neutron are in the nucleus, basically they are in the nuclei, and your electrons are revolving. So you have an idea ki okay, कोई मैटर है, उसको अगर छोटा करते चलते हैं तो वी विल गेट एन एटम, एंड एटम के अंदर भी एक three mainly subatomic particle होते हैं, electron, proton and neutron, in which proton and neutron are in the nuclei or nucleus and electron are revolving it. So we discuss कि okay inner structure अगर atom की बात करें then it is proton and neutron. Proton basically आपका positively charged particle and neutron are the neutral and but they have the mass. Whereas the outer structure, if we'll say, means if the nucleus is in the surrounding and the electrons are revolving it in a particular orbit or particular energy level given by the Niels Bohr, that is electron cloud, in which we have an electron is there which is negatively charged and surrounding across the nuclei. So you know, you have a basic understanding ki theek hai, ek nucleus hai, usme proton aur neutron hai, wo fixed hai, positive hai, uske around mein ek particular orbits mein electrons revolve kar rahe hain. How these electrons are distributed now? The question is how these electrons, I'm saying the electrons are revolving. How they are fixed means they have an special criteria, means they have some rules, like maximum number of the shell, means ek shell mein maximum number of electron is 2n raised to the power 2, means 2n square, whereas the n is the number of energy level, aap 1, 2, 3 keh lijiye, ya phir number of orbital. So first orbital if I am taking, which is k shell, so your number of electron in the k orbit is 2 into 1 raised to the power 2, that is 2. So ek nucleus ho gaya, jo uske just adjacent first hamara orbit aya, that is k shell. In the k shell there is a 2 electron that can be accumulated at max. After that L shell is come, in which there is 8 and so forth. So you know, this Bohr and Boris model will just restrict it to the 8 number of electron. Okay, octet rule ko follow karte, to maximum outermost orbit mein 8 electron rahenge, they told that. And they also said that electrons are not accomplished in a given shell, means एक पर्टिकुलर फॉलो में बढ़ता है. फर्स्टली यू विल फॉलो द इनर, मतलब लोअर एनर्जी, देन हायर, सो इट इज फॉलो अ सिस्टमैटिक पैटर्न टू फिल द नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन. सो यू कैन सी द न्यूक्लियस इज देयर, देन मैक्सिमम 2 इलेक्ट्रॉन इन द फर्स्ट विच इज द के शेल, देन मैक्सिमम 8 विच इज योर एल, फिर देन मैक्सिमम 8 दिस इज योर अगेन के एल एम. सो ये हमारा पैटर्न फॉलो होता है बेसिकली टिल 18 इलेक्ट्रॉन, जिनका एलिमेंट्स तक फॉलो होता है. आफ्टर दैट डिफरेंट होता है, बट इन योर कोर्स वी आर रिस्ट्रिक्टेड की ओनली के एल एम शेल ही वी आर डिस्कसिंग, सो आई एम रिस्ट्रिक्टेड ओवर हियर. सो यू अंडरस्टैंड दैट न्यूक्लियस इज देयर विच कंटेन द प्रोटोन एंड न्यूट्रॉन. आफ्टर दैट इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर रिवॉल्विंग. इलेक्ट्रॉन्स रिवॉल्विंग एक स्पेशल पाथ है विच इज एनर्जी लेवल्स. सो देयर इज के ऑर्बिटल, एल ऑर्बिटल एंड एम. सो के विल कंटेन द 2 इलेक्ट्रॉन एंड सो एंड सो फॉर. सो यू कैन सी इन दिस पैटर्न योर स्ट्रक्चर माइट बी. एक सिमेट्रिक डायग्राम, एक इमेजिनेशनरी पॉइंट वी कैन अंडरस्टैंड एटॉमिक स्ट्रक्चर कैन बी समथिंग लाइक दिस, कि 1, 2, 3 या के एल एम शेल हैं, न्यूक्लियस से बढ़ते रहते हैं एनर्जी लेवल पे. सो उसी के बेसिस पे आप समझ सकते हैं कि यू विल सी एच एटम में लाइक 1 आपका इलेक्ट्रॉन है, 1 प्रोटॉन है, सो इट्स लुक लाइक दिस. हीलियम है, तो हीलियम में आपका 2 इलेक्ट्रॉन आ गए, सो दे आर इन द फर्स्ट शेल. Once you are coming to the lithium or beryllium, so you are coming to the second shell, and consequently your electrons are increasing, number of electrons increasing, your orbital circles are increasing. So in your books we have only 18 elements you are there. I hope yahan tak aap logo ko clear hai. Now the question arises, what is valency? You know, NCERT mein if you'll see, it will come to the valency, because now once you understand the structure, then it's come to the part ki what is valency, means basically electron present in the outermost shell is called the valence electron, which play a most important role in any chemical reaction. So valency means the electrons, yeah, number of electrons present in the outermost shell. So they are saying ki according to Bohr-Bellé models, they are saying the maximum number is 8, octet rule follow hota hai, but it can be different for higher orders. So basically valency can be understood by the combining capacity, means how a element can combine with another element. So combining capacity of an atom, if we are discussing, so it is the tendency to react or and form the molecules with the atoms of same or different elements to attain or to get the octet full, means outer most. So basically if you are seeing कि हाइड्रोजन एटम है या लिथियम है या सोडियम है, दे विल हैव अ वन इलेक्ट्रॉन, सो देयर वैलेंसी इज वन. सो इन दैट पैटर्न वी कैन अंडरस्टूड की ओके वैलेंसी ऑफ मैग्नीशियम इट्स टू बिकॉज देयर नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन इन द आउटर मोस्ट शेल इज टू. फॉर एल्युमिनियम इट्स थ्री बिकॉज आउटर मोस्ट शेल इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इज थ्री. बट यू नो इट्स लिटिल बिट डिफरेंट व्हेन योर एलिमेंट इज क्लोजर टू द full capacity or outermost shell is going to be full. Like fluorine atom, if we are taking it, have a 7 electron, we know that. Now we cannot say ki its valency is 7. We can say because it is easy for chlorine to get 1 electron and complete its octet, so now the valency is 1. That given the sign will different. Like in the case of hydrogen, lithium or aluminium, we are giving the plus sign because they release their electron, they are giving their electron. But in case of fluorine, we are giving the symbol of minus 1 because they are taking the electron from the neighboring element or along with any other element to form the molecule. You will see a table in your NCERT books is given for 18 element in which you understand what is atomic number, at mass number and number of neutron, proton and electron and how they are distributed in different shells, means K element shell mein kaise distributed, and there is a column also there which shows the valency of your particular element in the table.
Sir, can you tell me that why is the valency different for all these atoms? Is there any particular reason for that?
Yes. Ma'am, valency basically defined the that particular element, how the element is going to react with others. Means every element wants to complete its octet. So for that, the valency concept is coming, which is basically the combining capacity, which is basically the capacity of a particular atom to complete its octet. So हर एलिमेंट का ये डिफरेंट डिफरेंट आपकी वैलेंसी रहती है. लाइक हाइड्रोजन है तो प्लस वन हुई, फ्लोरीन है तो माइनस वन, बिकॉज अगर हाइड्रोजन एक इलेक्ट्रॉन दे देता है सिस्टम में, इट विल अटेन अ ऑक्टेट इज कंप्लीटेड, उसका जीरो हो जाएगा, वो एक नोबल गैस या एक स्टेबल कंडीशन में आ जाएगा. फ्लोरीन अगर एक इलेक्ट्रॉन ले लेता है तो उसका इलेक्ट्रॉन आउटर मोस्ट शेल कंप्लीट हो जाएगा एंड इट इज कम टू द स्टेबिलिटी. सो दैट्स व्हाई यू नो वैलेंसी इज डिफरेंट एंड ऑल्सो इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट.
ओके
ओके मैम. नाउ मैम, देयर इज टू टर्म्स बेसिकली स्टूडेंट्स, एटॉमिक नंबर एंड मास नंबर. सो एटॉमिक नंबर, वी नो दैट एटॉमिक नंबर इज बेसिकली यू नो द नंबर ऑफ प्रोटॉन्स प्रेजेंट इन द न्यूक्लियस या एटम्स, दैट इज डिनोटेड बाय जेड. लाइक हाइड्रोजन है, सो इट्स हैव अ वन प्रोटॉन, सो मीन्स हाइड्रोजन हैव एटॉमिक नंबर वन. वेयर एज मास नंबर और एटॉमिक मास नंबर इज द sum of the mass of number of proton plus number of neutron in the system. Basically that's a nucleon. So therefore we can say that the mass of an atom is basically the mass of the nucleus, near about it, because electron don't have so much mass, so it does not affect. So like carbon, if we are taking, so carbon have 12 amu or u atomic mass unit, because 6 proton and 6 neutron, so they have the 12 unit or AMU, the mass atomic mass unit. So basically mass number is the sum of the total number of proton plus number of neutron present in the atom. You know, this notation you will see in the periodic table, like C is mentioned for carbon. So basically C is the atom symbol, the symbol we are using. The name of that particular atom is written just below to the C, that is carbon. The above one, you have seen that it is 6, which is the atomic number, or below it, this is the atomic mass, yeah, mass number of that particular atom. And also, the atomic number is number of proton plus or equal to the number of electron, because number of electron and protons are equal due to the charge neutrality of an atom that we discussed in the previous session. And atomic mass is basically the number of the mass of the number of protons plus mass of the number of neutrons. Now, you know, basically this show the characteristics, like number of protons in the nuclei is the number atomic number, or number of proton is equal to number of electrons. And also the atomic mass is the number of proton plus number of neutron. Inki SI unit standard international unit we are using, that is atomic mass unit AMU, or you can represent it by simple U. So for proton and neutron it is 1, and whereas for electron it is nearly 0. We are not considering the atomic mass unit of the electron. That's why I'm saying that whenever you are discussing about the atomic mass, it is basically the mass of your nucleus. या न्यूक्लियन जो भी उसमें आपका इलेक्ट्रॉन है या प्रोटॉन है उनका सबमिशन विल रिप्रेजेंट इट. नाउ वी विल डिस्कस, नाउ टिल दैट वी आर डिस्कसिंग कि ओके दैट इज द स्ट्रक्चर, देन वी आर डिस्कस द वैलेंसी, देन वी आर कमिंग टू द मास नंबर एंड एटॉमिक मास नंबर. देयर इज अ टू टर्मिनोलॉजी दैट यूज्ड इन योर चैप्टर इज आइसोटोप्स एंड आइसोबार. सो फर्स्टली वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट व्हाट इज आइसोटोप्स. सो यू नो isotopes are defined as the atom, the sum of elements, same element having the same atomic number. Means those, you know, in nature, it's naturally occurring. Whenever you are finding some element, they have the same atomic number but different mass number. Naturally, we will finding, means aapko naturally milenge, like hydrogen, if we are considering in case, you will see that hydrogen have a 3 isotopes. One is your protonium, that we all know H11 होता है, उसमें proton भी 1 है और आपका nuclei में भी 1 है. But we will also get along with the protonium the deuterium and tritium. Deuterium is the atomic number is 1 but atomic mass is 2. For tritium atomic mass become 3. So these kind of, you know, element that come occur in the nature have called the isotopes. So you know, like if you want to calculate the mass of any particular isotopes, if we are going like chlorine have a 2 isotopes, one is a 35 and another one is a 37. So in that case, their mass is not calculated as we are calculated previously. What we are calculated previously in the atomic mass, we are saying the atomic mass is something which is number of proton plus number of न्यूट्रॉन इन द न्यूक्लियाई में जो है आपका. बट फॉर आइसोटॉप्स वी यूज अ कॉन्सेप्ट कॉल एवरेज मास, बिकॉज हमें तो पता नहीं है कौन सा नेचुरली अकरिंग हमने लिया है. वी आर यू नो स्क्रैचिंग द यू नो सम ग्राम ऑफ क्लोरीन, सम ग्राम ऑफ दिस यूरेनियम और आयोडीन. सो वॉट एग्जैक्टली देयर मास इज, सो वी आर टेकिंग ओके वी आर टेकिंग द एवरेज मास ऑफ दैट. एवरेज मास इज फाइंडिंग आउट थ्रू देयर रेशो. लाइक इफ वी आर टेकिंग द केस ऑफ क्लोरीन, 35 and 37 is there, they are coming in the ratio of 3:1. So simply हमने calculation करनी है कि 35 into 3 ratio में है तो 75/100 रहा, and 37 हमारा 1 ratio में है, that is 25/100, and that we will get the 35.5. So you know, if you are randomly collecting the chlorine from the nature, you will say their average mass is 35.5 AMU या U, atomic mass unit. Now, what is, you know, use of these isotopes? So, if you are, you know, seeing that uranium-235, the isotopes of uranium, uranium-235, you already know that is used in a fuel in a nuclear reactor. Huge amount of energy can be created through that uranium-235, you know, creating the electricity for our system. Samely, in the isotopes of cobalt, which is cobalt-60. Cobalt-60, you know, it's a radioactive element, but it can also be used for a cancer treatment. Along with iodine-135, if you are seeing, iodine-135, you know, isotope is used for the goiter. Goiter basically, you know, advanced stage of thyroid, it will use to treat that particular disease. So these are the, you know, basic applications of your isotopes.
Sir, are there any characteristics now of isotopes as well?
Ma'am, basically, you know, isotopes we distinguish on their basis of the atomic mass. Once they have a different atomic mass, we can call it isotopes. They are naturally occurring. Matlab, ऐसा नहीं है कि हम प्रिपेयर करते हैं. दे आर यू नो कुछ एलिमेंट ऐसे हैं जो आपको मिलेंगे ही डिफरेंट आइसोटोप्स में. लाइक आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट यूरेनियम और कोबाल्ट और आयोडीन, क्लोरीन एंड दिस हाइड्रोजन. सो दे हैव अ यू नो, आप जब लेने जाओगे दे आर नॉट कमिंग आउट ऑफ द प्योर फॉर्म. वो प्योर फॉर्म में नहीं है. वो हाइड्रोजन आपको 1-1 चाहिए, बट इट इज आल्सो बी 2-1, दैट्स कॉल्ड ड्यूटेरियम. इट्स आल्सो बी 3-1, दैट्स कॉल्ड द ट्रिटेरियम. सो बेसिकली आइसोटोप्स इज समथिंग यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड इट कि दे हैव द सेम एटॉमिक नंबर but different atomic mass.
Okay.
Okay, ma'am. So now at last terminology that we are left, that is the isobar, which is very easy. Basically, isobars are those which have the same mass number but different atomic number. Isotopes का आपका atomic number different है, mass number आपका same था, but उधर element same था. If you example, we are talking about hydrogen, deuterium or tritium, but all three are family of hydrogen. Here we are taking like calcium have a atomic number 20 and argon have atomic number 18, but their mass are coming out to be 40. So such kind of material are called as isobar. Means isotopes mein kya hai, unki chemical property doesn't change, but they have the same family, like I am talking about chlorine or hydrogen, they are the same. So their chemical property doesn't change, although their physical property changed, but we are mainly concerned about chemical properties, that's why there is no issue. But in case of isobar, their chemical properties also changed, because calcium is totally different with argon. Although they are isobar, calcium have an atomic mass of 20, atomic number of 20, but atomic mass is 40. Whereas argon, its atomic number is 18 and its mass is 40. So such kind of elements are, atoms are called as isobars. These are basically the two terminology that's used, so that you will be able to understand or create some curiosity. Okay, once you know the structure, you know the valency, you know the distribution of electron, you have some idea. Okay, such kind of the different families are also be there in the structure.
Okay, sir, we have last couple of minutes left. I would request you to please wrap up.
Okay, ma'am, I'll just wrap up what we have actually did in this whole two sessions.
Okay.
So initially we started with the finding out the atoms structure. That's given the ancient time by the Greek and Indian philosopher. Kanakvil also said that the smallest thing in the atom in the nature is the parmanu, and similarly Greek philosopher also explained the smallest part is atomos. After that, first experimentally model given by the J.J. Thomson and Rutherford, after it will improved by the Niels Bohr. Till the course of they have Niels Bohr model, they have to do in their 9th class. And also in today's session we discussed how the shells will filled by the electrons, how the electrons are filled in the shells, how the valency will affect any particular element or atom, and what are the isotopes and isobars we are discussed. Along with in the previous class, we also understand the discovery of electron, that's done by the J.J. Thomson, then discovery of proton done by the Goldstein, and the discovery of neutron did by the Chadwick.
Okay,
so basically I hope students you are able to understand what is the structure of atom and how it is important and implementation for the further studies.
Absolutely, sir. I am sure the students have understood the concept of structure of the atom. Thank you so much for being with us, and it was a wonderful session indeed. Thank you once again.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you. Namaste, bachcho. Thank you.
Thank you to all the viewers as well for being a part of our program. I really think that you enjoyed the entire session. And if in case you have missed it, please watch it on our YouTube channel so that you can get a revision of it. So with this, we are wrapping up this particular science program where we discussed structure of the atom. Upcoming next program is a maths class, and we are going to study the pair of linear equations in two variables. And this is going to be the first part of this topic. If you have any questions, please feel free to raise it. Thank you so much. I'm Tanvi Khurana, and I'll take a leave of you. Have a nice day. Namaskar.